Once upon a time, there was a lonely, bitter old man, a bookbinder, who longed to write stories that would touch the world's heart, though he was said to not have one himself.
If they will spurn my stories, I shall rewrite theirs. I will tear down their heroes. I will make their tragedies my triumph and make them see the truth. Let me have the wolf by my side, the honesty of its hunger. Give me the wicked witch and the evil ogre. Give me the darkest depth of the human soul. I will bind them together with blood and give the world a new story. A lesson for them all to remember. Never let genius go unrecognized. Once upon a time. Once upon a time, there was a girl whose skin was white as snow. She fled her wicked stepmother and found safety in the forest with 7 dwarves. But this was not her forest.
"Where am I?" said Snow White. "I do not know these trees. I do not know these paths. How will I ever find my way home?"
Just then, a foul beast appeared, its teeth sharp and diseased. Before Snow White could do anything to fend off the nightmare,
a man in green emerged from the undergrowth.
"Marian?"
said the man the people hailed as Robin Hood.
"No. Forgive me. Your face... it is similar, but... you should be careful where you wander, milady. These woods can be treacherous for one so fair."
"I have learned to take care of myself these past years, friend Archer," said Snow White. "Few of them have shown any interest in fairness. But pray, whose forests are these? Which king do you serve?"
"One who is a better symbol than sovereign, I fear," sighed the outlaw, though his warmth never wavered.
"Come, you are not the only lost soul I have stumbled across this day."
The outlaw took Snow to his camp and his other guest, the doctor, whose name was Jekyll and whose secret was Hyde. "Fret not," said Robin Hood, "for you are under my protection, and few who are not friends of the people steer their venture into the forest of Sherwood. On my honor, we will find the paths back to your realms. My outlaw's honor, for at least I can take pride in my crimes."
But the good doctor was afraid of something, of eyes that stared back through the undergrowth.
Would they be counted as friends of the people?
"No," said the idealistic fool in green. "No, they most certainly would not."
The archer readied his bow. "If we must fight, I would know who I fight beside. They call me Snow White. Dr. Henry Jekyll, at your service."
"Excellent. And I was Robin, Lord of Locksley. And by my bow, I shall be so again.
Now then, gentlemen, who's first?"
Oh!